asked me to thank all of you for joining us today at the AFL-CIO book series for a discussion of the book 16 Times by Kevin Corley. Let's welcome Kevin.
Hello.
And I told him with reading so many ways, he'll like some of them before he gets out of here. So that, you're much friends here. This is a novel about immigrant workers set in the American coal fields of a century ago. It is an important story that comes to us at a critical time. Kevin has written a book that is full of historical insights and information. Although it is a work of fiction, it is largely grounded in thorough research, including interviews with and recollections of people who lived through the events Kevin discusses. And this is the part he brags on me, and I'm sure everybody wants to hear that, so I'll skip that. This is going to be a great... This is a great conversation, and I'm terribly sorry to miss it. Yet I'd like to say a few more words about Kevin's novel. It was interesting for me to review because I also have a fair amount of knowledge of these same events and conditions. Coming from stories I heard from my father and grandfather and my uncles and others from my hometown, it's great to see this material in a novel because Kevin's words bring to life the dreams and aspirations of the men, women, and children who lived our labor history, a history which has been pretty well pushed aside and papered over in the United States. Most of us know the inspiring words from the Declaration of Independence, words about life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. A few people today know the lengths that some of the families have gone in search of a decent life, true liberty, and a chance of happiness. They traveled across oceans of water and over expanses of land. They dug and blasted deep into the earth. They endured the cave-ins and hard manual labor, sometimes in coal mines only 3 feet high. In fact, the descriptions of the mine work itself is fascinating. Because it is written so anyone today can get an understanding of a miner's workday back then. It wasn't easy, but it was work for people who needed it. Kevin's book covers another important and too often overlooked aspect. The unionism and an extreme backlash against any and every form of solidarity. This is part of American history that needs to be remembered. A lot of this stuff is heartbreaking, and it should break hearts. Company gunmen hounded and killed men, women, and children for no crime other than trying to earn a living. Yet there were far more crimes, perhaps less dramatic in scope, but more devastating. I'm thinking of the casual story in the novel as related by a ship boss, about a man whose long legs were caught in a roof fall. To get him out, one leg was cut off above the knee. After the amputation, the boss joked, "The miner was better in the lower tunnels." If this struggle against dehumanization forces that this novel is really about, we see similarities today, as so many people talk casually about illegal aliens. While authorities arrest and deport immigrants today, tearing families apart for the crime of looking for work, that's wrong and it needs to stop. I could go on and on about this book all day, and in fact, I have planned on it, but other demands on my time have made it impossible. Instead, I'll wrap up by saying I'm proud the AFL-CIO is hosting the discussion of this novel. I'm glad it's part of the AFL-CIO book series, and I hope the novel reaches a broad audience. Please join me in welcoming Kevin and Cecil Roberts.